So family, we're here with Alisa, who is our brother Gabriel's sister. We're getting ready to go in the waters of baptism, for a true biblical baptism, to break the chains, to be completely free from sin, for the remission of sins, right? And so last night, we had a beautiful experience with the Lord, where He stayed true to His word, and He brought deliverance just like He promised. And so, Alisa, you want to share a little bit about just maybe what led up to this, you know, what happened, how you feel after last night and stuff like that?
Yeah, so it was like really crazy. I'm actually from California, and my brother was here in Florida. He'd only been here for about a week, and I just wanted to run away. I just wanted to get away, so I booked a flight here to Florida, not really knowing why I came here, but you know, God had it planned all along. Upon getting here, I think, before coming here, I was in a very like hopeless state. I had just backslid like crazy. I really was just like lost. I didn't really know what was next in my life. But I think coming here, there's so much hope restored. I really saw just like this house fellowship that's here, all the things that God is doing here, and I was like, whoa, this is really like God's word coming to life, and this is really like still happening now. You know, it didn't end then. And so there's just so much hope restored as I was here. And then last night, as you know, this brother was just sharing about like just the gospel and everything, and they just like prayed for my deliverance and to be free. I feel free. Like, I don't know, everything was like just lifted off, you know? Hallelujah. Really, things that were battled with like from childhood my whole life have just been broken. And I'm just excited and I'm happy that this is what God has had planned like all along.
Amen. So, praise God. Yes. Glory to God alone.
Amen. Yeah.
And
Amen.
So we talked and we went into the scripture. Yeah. We read what the scripture had to say about baptism, about being born again, about getting on this path of salvation. And so she decided she wants the full deal, the real deal, and she wants to bury the old Alisa, and that's what we're going to do right now.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name. So let's go through the water.
Amen.
Oh, I've got my sandals on. Let me kick those off.
Such a beautiful day. Hello. Dios y a Dios.
Amen. Amen. Baptized in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
It's nice after you dunk yourself.
Yeah, now I feel like it.
Let's pray for her to receive the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah.
I just figured if you guys got wet, I'll get wet too.
Ooh, amen. Hallelujah. God is good. As soon as we started talking about how we're going to go, now all the waves started coming.
Yeah. All the waves started coming.
Yeah.
So, let me just put this out. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. The old Elisa dead and buried, getting dragged off into the sea.
Amen.
Never to be seen again.
Amen.
The old Elisa is carrying too much burden. She's not able to come back up out of the water.
Yeah. Amen.
So now, we're going to pray that you receive the Holy Spirit of God. Yeah. Baptized in the Holy Spirit with the evidence that we see in the scripture and all around us of speaking in tongues. And so your only job is when you feel the Holy Spirit bringing that spiritual language out of your mouth, you just don't resist it, don't fight it, don't be embarrassed. You just let it flow, okay? And begin to speak in tongues. I'm gonna pray for you. We're gonna pray for you. But first, I just want you to say, Jesus, please come with your Holy Spirit.
Please come with your Holy Spirit.
And baptize me now.
And baptize me now.
Holy Spirit, please enter in.
Holy Spirit, please enter in.
Holy Spirit, fill her up like never before, Father God. Overwhelm her, baptize her, Lord. You know the promise in your word. And if we repent from our sins and are baptized in the name of Jesus Christ, that we have your promise to receive the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, enter in now and just begin to flow out of your mouth in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Spirit, fill her up more and more and more. We thank you, Lord. We give you praise. Even if it's a single syllable, we just want to speak it and cooperate with the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, come now, please. We give you glory, Father God. Fill her up more and more and more, Father God. Baptize her in your Holy Spirit, Father God. Soro Holini to be Sanara Basona. Holy Spirit, rise up. That flow out of her mouth, Father God. Soro Kilana Rabasona. You do it, Father God, by your sovereign hand, by your might. Not by our own effort, not by our power, or by our strength, but by your spirit, Father God. Just let the tongue that you've already given us flow, Father God, in Jesus' mighty name. More and more and more, Lord. You are mighty and worthy to be praised. Flow, Holy Spirit, flow. We thank you, Father God. We glorify your holy name. We give you glory, Father God. You are mighty and worthy to be praised. There is nobody like you, nobody above you, nobody that can stand before you. You are love, and you have poured your love. I pray that the love of the Father enter in right now like never before. The peace of our princes Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, sister, for letting the Holy Spirit flow. And sometimes He'll give us that one syllable, right? But as we begin to cooperate with the Holy Spirit, it just begins to flow. Do that on your own time, in your own prayer time. As you feel it rise up, let it flow, and the Lord will do amazing things.
Amen.
I'm so happy for you, sister. Congratulations. God bless you.
Amen.
God bless you.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He is mighty and worthy to be praised.
Amen.
How do you feel?
I feel good.
Amen. Praise
Amen.
The Lord.